Eastlund Scientific Enterprises Corporation, site. Site of Bernard Eastlund. This is video two. The first one was an introduction to the site. And today, I'm going to go into a little bit more about one of the most hot topics that most people are talking about, and that is HAARP. So over here it has solutions, his vision, speaking, resumes, proposals, HAARP, weather, tornado, cosmic plasma, fusion, torch, plasma processors, space cities, industrial astrophysics, contacts, symbiotic nuclear, the Hanford Project, Armageddon scenarios, and the jet stream maps. Okay, so let's go right into HAARP. Here's a picture of a HAARP transmission, and here's the patent. Here's the introduction. HAARP is a large-phased array electromagnetic wave generator located in Alaska. The involvement of Dr. Bernard Eastlund in its creation has been well documented. During the period in which many of the books and articles were written, Dr. Eastlund was under a 15-year confidentiality agreement with ARCO, the Atlantic Richfield Company. That confidentiality agreement has now matured. The website will present information regarding the development of the ARCO patents. They're all in there. And the founding of APTI, which is now owned by AES Corporation. That is the corporation that is managing the HAARP facility. The website is divided into four sections. HAARP Roots presents a historical material. Roadmap, it's a compendium of most of the ideas developed between 1984 and 1987. The work Mr. Eastlund did with ARCO. And then we have the HAARP. Wattage describes the present status of the HAARP related to the ARCO patents. And then we have HAARPASAT. Section describes a potentially destabilizing applications of missile defense and as an anti-satellite weapon. And then we have ASAT, HAARP Weather, discusses potential impacts of the HAARP device on weather and weather research. So, let's just go straight into the HAARP roots. The beginning. Dr. Eastlund was approached by ARCO in the spring of 1984 and asked to invent an idea that could lead to the sale of the 23 trillion cubic feet of natural gas in the Prudhoe Bay formation on the north slope of Alaska. He presented a concept for using the gas to power a large phased array electromagnetic generator and produce a missile shield to defend the United States from missile attacks by the Soviet Union. Many other ideas for applications were developed, and most of them are detailed in the roadmap. Many of these ideas are part of the present DARPA-managed HAARP program. This just kind of shows a little bit of the foundation and the connections that he had. This particular statement here between the meeting that he had with ARCO was a confidential piece of paper that it says is confidential, and he promised to never duplicate it. The ARCO property to be protected in the same manner as the report. Eastlund agreed to make no copies of any of this information. Okay, so, and these are the early years, and what some of his ideas were. HAARP roadmap. Roadmap for North Slope Gas Concept Development. A roadmap for the North Slope Gas Development was developed in included concepts from the original three ARCO patents and new ideas developed or embellished by subcontractors from the Titan Systems Corporation and SAIC Corporation. The major subsections of the roadmap were a ballistic missile shield, strategic space weapon defense, ASAT, which is an anti-satellite weapon, satellite corridor formation, the Van Allen belt drainage, over the horizon reflector, ionospheric patch formation, communications with ELF and VLF, detection and discrimination, satellite interrogation, ground-to-space power beaming, ARCO satellite gas station, nuclear weapons effect simulation, atmospheric modifications, weather modification, environmental modifications, space elevator, ballistic missile launch detection, synergistic applications, and enhanced oil recovery. So in here we have the history in HAARP's roots indicates progress in some of these areas. The HAARP facility itself was an outgrowth of this roadmap. Okay, this is on the left is a full global shield. That is a strategic space weapon defense designed for ballistic missile patch shields. The mission was to produce localized regions of high energy electrons with flux levels necessary for discrimination, upset, or hard kill. They also have a patent for a partial drift shell, which would obviously protect only a partial area, and those applications were for detection and discrimination. The mission was to detect and discriminate re-entry vehicles in the presence of P-nates. The concept was to produce regions of relativistic electrons in the path of a threat cloud and use the radiation from the resulting interactions to determine the location of re-entry vehicles. Now, this was back during the Cold War, so their purpose back then was to deal with Russia. In which the energy is stored for a second or more, then released in a short millisecond burst. This could increase the flux at altitude by a factor of 1,000 to 10,000. This would increase the flux to 2.1 milliwatts. The HIPAA system in Alaska ran in a pulse mode in the 1980s. Also, we have heard that the recent upgrade actually cost around $200 million. That was for the pulse capability installation. The lens effect. It is possible to create a lens in the ionosphere short of the desirable electron acceleration point and focus the power on a much smaller area than assumed in the HAARP calculator. Such a method of operation could increase the flux factor of 10 or more if both pulsed and lensing were used. The flux would be very close to the 0.5 watts in the theory. The acceleration of electrons in the ionosphere to MeV energies was considered the most important application of the Eastlund ARCO patents when they were under development. It may still be one of the DoD priorities. This facility and the ARCO patents have been made public for a number of years. Any country could build one. HAARP is not built with overly sophisticated technology. And in fact, China does have one for sure. Here we have the Renaissance heating of electrons. The core hypothesis underlying behind the ARCO patents was to generate copious amounts of MeV electrons along magnetic field lines above the Earth's surface. Resonance energy can be applied many ways to objects. So here we have the Earth-based antenna. They shoot up an RF heating beam, Renaissance heating beam, using MeV electrons, going up, going into the heating cycle, which is forced through the Earth's magnetic field and up into a satellite. A resonance heating method of creating MeV electrons using RF waves was developed and exploited by the Oak Ridge National Laboratory. Subsequent plasma devices have generated MeV electrons in the laboratory with resonant heating. The ARCO patents by Dr. Eastlund hypothesized a large phased array antenna located in Alaska with its RF energy focused at altitudes 100 kilometers or more above the Earth. The system is illustrated at the top of the page. The frequency was chosen to be in the 1 to 3 megahertz range to create an electron resonance heating that would create MeV electrons along the magnetic field lines. The RF beam is shown in yellow in the figure. The heating process is depicted as a helix along a magnetic field line. The electrons spiral along the field line with increasingly large orbits as their energy increases. MeV electrons are formed, and a magnetic mirror force pushes the electrons away from the Earth and along the magnetic field lines. When such electrons impinge on a missile, warhead, or satellite, they are buried in the material and heat components. In the case of a missile warhead, this can lead to total destruction. In the case of a satellite, it can make the satellite inoperative. The first DoD contract regarding the ARCO patents by Eastlund was from DARPA and was entitled the Alaska North Slope Electric Missile Shield. The objective was to determine the feasibility of generating the MeV electrons and determining the feasibility of the applications. Then, in our opinion, this could be the greatest threat to modern military satellite technology. A geosynchronous satellite could be eliminated within 20 minutes. There is some indication that other countries such as China are working on such technologies. Yes, China is at the South Pole. Modification is in its infancy. When the ARCO patents were written in 1984, the only scientific approach was salting clouds with silver iodide. This talks about the power that's needed and the power that they got.
Okay, I think that's enough on just the basics of what HAARP really is, and we will go into a little bit more of some of these patents and some of the applications that are being used today, and maybe eventually we can actually have a little bit of a forum an open forum. We can get somebody to do that. Alrighty, God bless. Yeah.